I think Charles Key's work is absolutely outstanding, and it continues to be. Even to this day, we're looking at 16 years on, almost coming this April. Charles took a lot of risks.
When we saw what was going on with the investigation and that it was trying to move away from the early facts that were presented by law enforcement, by the media, we pursued establishing a county grand jury in Oklahoma County, something unique to Oklahoma and just a few other states in the country that allows citizens' grand juries to be impaneled to investigate things such as this.
The committee meetings were very serious. We fought the government at every level, all the way through to the Supreme Court of the state.
We had a lot of people that came forward and brought us a lot of information that we wouldn't have gotten any other way. We were pursuing all the information that we could get our hands on about the bombing, and we were trying to get a congressional investigation of the bombing.
I was in awe at the amount of effort that they put in that first 6.5 years before the book was released. And then they had the book released, come out to the general public 3 weeks before 9/11 occurred. And to see every single obstacle that was thrown in their face, from all the way from the news media to financial to emotional, and interviewing over 329 victims, family members, and survivors. And these people were consistently basically saying, I am not going to fail. I'm not going to quit. I want the truth to come out on this.
So we formed the Oklahoma County Grand Jury to have essentially a citizen's investigation into the Oklahoma bombing. And that caused us to have to get together a number of signatures from citizens of Oklahoma County, which we did.
We got, 11, 12,000 signatures. We only were required 5,000. And by getting all those signatures, getting them validated and everything, we then got X amount of money, a lot of money, and the opportunity to set up a grand jury. Well, they turned the grand jury over to our enemy, which was Bob Macy, and basically gave him the money, and then he proceeded to investigate us.
I wrote a letter to the district attorney, Macy, told him what I had seen and that I wanted to testify in the grand jury. I got a letter back from him telling me that the grand jury did not want to hear anything I had to say about the bombing.
After the Oklahoma County grand jury was actually initially formed, then there were some efforts to try to stop that by the Oklahoma County DA and others. And at that time, we organized ourselves in a more formal way. We hired private investigators and some others to help us put the information that we had gathered together in a form that we could present to that county grand jury.
4, 5, 6 months into the investigation, we started suspecting that our phones were tapped. And I don't remember how we got the information, but we were given a number that we could dial, and it would either confirm or that were tapped or that they weren't. And we dial this number, it would confirm it. We didn't really have anything to hide, so it didn't really make that much difference. It didn't affect our investigation too much.
I think as we finalized our work, as we got to the end, as that grand jury was impaneled, and as we put this report together, we had a lot of media that was waiting for this report. They were ready to give it some significant coverage. And our report came back from the book publisher about 2 weeks before 9/11. And one of the things that we said and some others said during that time frame, as before and after 9/11, that the reason that we did this is because if you don't ask the questions and you don't hold government accountable in everything that it does, not just bombings like this, but everything, then you'll have the same mistakes happen again, and they will get worse as time goes on.